Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalms 23. A passage of comfort, John 14. I will read verses 1 through 7. Let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there you'll be also. And whether I go, ye go, and the way ye know. Thomas said to him, Lord, we know not where thy going, and how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. If ye had known me, you should have known my Father also. And from henceforth, you know me and have seen me. Welcome to the homegoing celebration of Dwight Culver. What we feel, we're going to lift up the name of Jesus. I am Evangelist Lori Gill, and we will follow the order of service as followed. So we will have our prayer of comfort by Juan Cruz, our scripture by Willie Johnson, then we'll have a music selection, and then acknowledgments by Sister Linda Adams. And then I'll call you up for reflections.
We're going to open up with prayer as we do in any service and any celebration. We worship God and God alone, and that's who we come to praise and worship even though in these times. We're going to pray. Father God, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we give you all the thanks, honor, and glory, Lord. Even for a day like today, Father God, we realize, Lord God, that we are to be joyful. Joyful, Lord, because you, my Lord God, are good. Joyful, Lord, because even you know how it is to have someone pass away. You had your Son die for our sins, Father God. For that we rejoice. We give you thanks, honor, and glory, because we know that to be absent from the body is indeed to be present with you, my Lord. We pray right now, Lord, for a comforting spirit, Lord, to come around each and every one of us. We pray, Father God, for the family, Lord God, for the Culver family, to have joy that may surpass their understanding, my Lord God, and for you, Lord, to dwell in their hearts forever and ever. We pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, so that you may remind, Lord, the family, that you will never leave them nor forsake them. And joyfully, Lord God, praying that we know that you have prepared a place for our brother in heaven. If it were not true, you would not have put it in your holy scriptures. We give you all the thanks, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Our Old Testament reading will be coming from Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still water. He restores my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Neither do I walk through the valley in the shadow of death. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod, thy staff, that comfort me. New Testament is coming from John 14, starting at the first verse. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto me, myself, that where I am, that you may be also. May God have a blessing to the reading of his word.
We'll have our music selection by Willie Johnson. William H. Culver.
Thank you.
reverence to God. Romans 8th chapter, 2nd verse. For the law of the Spirit of Jesus Christ hath made me free from the law of sin and death. The family feels blessed by your presence here today. They would like to thank you for your support during their time of sorrow. They appreciate all of your prayers, concerns, love, flowers, and cards. Many cards have been received. These have been chosen by the family to share with you. University of Laverne, dear Culver family, we're sorry for your loss of Dwight Culver. May memories provide comfort through this difficult time. Our thoughts and prayers are with you. Best regards, Lucario Roja, Alumni Relations Manager, University of Laverne. What you leave behind is not what is engraved in stone monuments, but what is woven into the lives of others. To the family of Dwight Culver, my sincere condolences for your loss. Everyone at work still thinks about Dwight each day. I pray you will find peace and comfort in most of these difficult circumstances. We are praying for the family and hope we can be of any assistance if you need it. I will always cherish these memories of being around Dwight. He always brought a smile to my face, and we would always end up laughing out loud. Normally, because that's the type of guy Dwight is. A guy who always stayed positive and tried to brighten up the day. I will miss him dearly. Joseph J. Young. May it bring you comfort to know that one so special will live forever in our hearts. When someone dies, their spirit lives on in us. We can't hug them or see them with our eyes, but we can still feel them in our hearts. That brings me comfort. I hope it does for you too. When we love someone, they become an indelible force in our lives. Even after they are gone, we remember the way they told a joke, wore their hair, or walked into a room. The littlest things will trigger memories of the sound of their voice, their scent, the times we spent with them. We recall how they dealt with hard situations. When we are faced with the same things, we think about them for no reason at all. What would they say right now? We will always wonder, are they watching over us? Do they know how much we miss them? Even though we'll never see loved ones who passed on, we walk through the front door again. I hope you can find peace with the knowledge that you'll always have a part of them with you. When we love someone, their spirit lives forever in our hearts. I'm so sorry for your loss. Love, Mom. The Culver family received several acknowledgments, and these are some of the acknowledgments that they have requested to be read. This is from the Trawick family resolution in loving memory of Dwight Culver. He dwelleth in the secret place of the Most, shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Psalm 91, first and second verse. Mrs. Juanita Culver and family. We, the members of the Trawick family reunion, were deeply saddened to hear of the sudden passing of our beloved, generous, smiling, comical, distinguished husband, father, brother, uncle, cousin, friend, mentor, and the epitome of a strong black family man. Whereas the Trawick family is very certain that this is not only a heartfelt loss of a beloved and cherished loving family, but also a strong role model to our family and closest of friends. Whereas we concur that the loss is untimely, painful, and full of extreme sorrow. The traumatic loss of our family member is one which has pierced our hearts very deeply. Yet, at that same time, we bow in thankfulness to our Almighty God that he is now free from this earthly realm and has transitioned into the glory of the Lord. Whereas Dwight was a valued and revered member of the Troward family. Reunion. Let us reflect back to the 36th Troward family reunion. All roads led by bus, plane, train, or car to our family roots in Dothan, Alabama. And there he was, whether in the hallways of the museum, the aisles of the bus, or standing in line to enjoy good food while taking pictures of relatives sharing about our eventful and respective childhood experiences. Therefore, be it resolved, the passing of our beloved Dwight is the will of the Almighty God, and there is a human tie that has been broken which leaves our hearts in agony. Be it further resolved, the Troward family will also remember our beloved one with joyous memories and happy times that he shared with our family while he was still here on earth. Family, let us continue to pray for one another as we find peace and solace for our soul and accept what is the divine will of our Creator. Victoriously submitted in love, the Troward Family Reunion, written by Cousin Evangelist Karen Troward Wallace. Resolution. Death beckoned him with outstretched hands and whispered softly of an unknown land. But he was not afraid to go, for though the path he did not know, he took death's hand without a fear, for he who safely brought him here had told him he would lead the way into eternity's bright day. And so he did not go alone into the valley of that unknown. He gently took death by the hand and journeyed to the promised land, wherein, in the providence of God, he called home to glory our beloved brother and cousin, Dwight Culver, on September 19, 2016. The Alabama Troward Family Reunion Committee feels that it is befitting to express our deepest sympathy to our beloved cousin's family. Whereas he has gone from labor to reward, his presence will be greatly missed by his loved ones, his community, and all who knew him. Be it further resolved that the prayers and heartfelt sympathy of the Alabama Troward Family Reunion Committee are extended to the family we love you all. Life's race well won, life's work well done, life's crown well won, and now the rest. Omni submitted and sorrowfully done, the Troward Family Reunion Alabama Committee, Teresa McKissick Smith, Chairperson. This is from the West Los Angeles Church of God in Christ. To Juanita Culver and family, to the Dwight Culver family, comfort and grace be unto you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, our love and prayers are extended to your family. The West Los Angeles Church family is sorry to hear of your loved one's transition. Jesus promised in Matthew 11, chapter 28, verse, that if we come to him, he will cause us to rest, to be at ease, and would relive and refresh our souls. We encourage your family to pray to the Lord Jesus and experience his comfort for your bereaved hearts. We are fully persuaded that as you look to Jesus and allow him to embrace you with his love, you will experience Philippians 4, chapter 7, verse, and the peace of God which passeth all understanding shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. We love you and will continue to pray for your family. Bishop Charles E. Blake, pastor of and Lady May Blake, and the West Los Angeles Church family. This is from the New York Jets. Dear Culver family, we are the New York Jets. We at the New York Jets would like to express our condolences to your family on the loss of Dwight. We appreciate his lifelong devotion to our team. Just as Dwight showed his support for the Jets, we now stand beside you in your time of sorrow. His passion and enthusiasm for the team will be missed. We hope that the many fond memories of Dwight will vividly shine for you in the years ahead. Sincerely, New York Jets.
Everybody all right?
Yes.
Dwight, awesome man, awesome man. We're gonna have reflections. If you're on the program for reflections, if you can line up right here to my left, your right. We're gonna give you about 2.5 minutes to reflect on how awesome Mr. Dwight Culver was in your life. We have Lavina Williams, James Carl Culver, Rob Vasquez, and Henry Pandis.
Good morning.
Good morning.
First, give an honor to the Almighty and Wise God who allowed all of us to be here. I'm glad about it, because he didn't have to do it. Oh, but he did. To Evangelist Gill, to my companion Samuel Williams, to all the other ministers, to Juanita, to the Culver family, and friends. It gives me great pleasure to stand before you on behalf of the Culver family, and I promise you to speak very briefly on our beloved baby brother, Dwight Culver. When I received the call of Dwight passing on September the 19th, around 3 o'clock p.m., I thought about what the Bible said. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Do you see, our parents raised us to be a loving family. It was Lanier, who was the oldest, and then that was Brenda, the oldest girl, followed by Gwendolyn, who's deceased. Then there was Dora, myself. And then 10 years later, came our bundle of joy. Amen. Dwight, we shared the same birth month with our father, and he never, never let me forget that. You know, I know life that you live, it speaks for yourself. And the memories that I have of Dwight are his early years, when he was the baby and I no longer was the baby. I thought about his school days, and you know, I think we might have spoiled him just a little bit. His school days, he was always late. Football practice, we're not gonna talk about that. And his holidays, you know, I never could get his toys right. I was Santa's helper, and for some reason, the toys just would not stay put together. So we had a problem with his toys. You know, it's hard to say goodbye to yesterday, but there's a song that we sing back home, and the words are, when peace, like a river, attended my way. When sorrows like sea pillow roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul.
Yes.
Though Satan should buffer, though trials should come, Let this blessed assurance control that Christ has regarded my helpless estate and has shed his own blood for my soul.
Yes.
It is well. It is well. It is well with my soul.
Amen. Amen.
Good night. Sleep tight. Take your rest.
Yes.
We love you, Dwight.
We love you. Yes.
Good morning to everyone. Dwight and I were first cousins, and really close cousins because two brothers married two sisters. And my mom called me Johnny Come Lately because just as Dwight, I was unexpected. She thought she was done. And so we both were the baby in the family, and we both were spoiled a little bit. But, you know, one thing I want you to know about our family, and my cousin Lavinia is just a tip of it. Such strong women of God in our family.
Yes.
And, you know, the seeds are planted early in our life.
Yes.
And go back to my grandmother, who was a mother of the church, and my mom's mother of the church, and Dwight's mother was pastor of a church, and everyone had a song in their heart. Everyone had verses to know and had that relationship with God at an early age. And so I know where Dwight is at. I'm very comforted by that because I know, as that parable of the sower of the seed, that he will come back to him in times of trouble and need. And I know that when he was having his preparation for his surgery, that he called on the Lord. I know my cousin that way. It's instilled in us. So our family has that faith. And then the other thing that I love so much about my cousin, that he dared to dream big, you know. And again, going back with our faith, you know, that familiar passage in Philippians, I can do all things. And he believed that. And I was given a challenge after his dad died. And our fathers were close. And their mother passed away. They really didn't know their father. And because he died very young. And my father asked me after his father died early on in his service in the Navy to look over and watch Dwight. Not to be overbearing or anything, but I had my father was still alive, and I lived close to my parents in Florida. And he wanted me to do that checking on with Dwight. And so I started doing that, especially in the 90s. My job brought me out to Los Angeles, and I was coming every month for a few years. So every month we got together and we shared good times. And I could always tell the family, as Cousin Lavinia just said, all is well. And then something wonderful happened in his life, and when he met Juanita, saw a change.
Yes.
I loved how the family adopted him,
yes.
George and Ethel.
Yes.
Things that the pastor made for him, finding him a job, and she supported him through the school years, and I was so pleased, and I could always report back that all was well in California. All was well with Dwight. So he finished, he got the job with DCMA, and I was very happy because I've been a federal employee for many years, and so he was on that path. Everything was going well, and then he got that call. call to come home.
Yeah.
And it's a difficult call to take sometimes for us that are not on the receiving end, because we're going to miss them so much. We have so much more to talk about.
Yes.
Things we're looking up for them. But in my heart, and I truly say this, I know where he's at.
Yes.
And that's the challenge that he would have for each one of us. When you get that call, as Mama would say, you got to be ready.
Yes.
Be ready when you get that call. So I know in the seventh place, he was saving us to be ready.
Yes.
And again, lastly, I just want to thank all of you that were his colleagues, his friends, his neighbors, how he embraced the family, embraced him these many years. And we love you so much.
Yes.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My name is Henry Pandez, Dwight Supervisor with the Defense Contract Management Agency, DCMA. There are many members here from DCMA, so if you're from DCMA or used to work for DCMA, please stand up. You're recognized. On the 19th of September, I got a phone call on my desk. It was about 1:15. And it was a phone call from Nina. And Kathy and I had been at the house on the 16th, Friday, and we saw Dwight. And Dwight was full of energy, on the road to rehabilitation. He had lost 30 pounds. Kathy and I, we were just amazed at how far Dwight had come. So that evening, we left Dwight's house, and Nina and Dwight were in the driveway, and we said goodbye. I drove away, and Kathy was still there. So when I got the phone call on the 19th at 1:15, it broke my heart. There's no other way to say it. It broke my heart. And I wanted to say it. I don't think this phone call is real, but it was real, because I didn't want it to be true. So after I got through the shock of taking the phone call, my next challenge was to tell my coworkers what had happened. And I got everyone together in a circle, and we talked to amongst each other, and we held hands. We held hands as a team because I got the news from Nina. So with DCMA, he has another family, and I want the immediate family to know that. He had another family at home. He had another family at work. From 6:30 on till about 3:30 or so, Dwight was Monday through Friday working for the government, working for the Department of Defense. On behalf of Ms. Owsley, DCMA Santa Ana, on behalf of Lieutenant Colonel Aldrich and Ms. Joanne Holland, on behalf of Katie Smith, and DCMA Raytheon LA, we are so sorry for the Culver family. We miss Dwight incredibly. Since the 19th, it's been very difficult for us as an office, because we all have very fond memories. What we did here in this box, we all wrote cards, and they did a personal note for Nina and the family, and I'm going to give this to Nina real quick. Let me try to recap in a very brief moment here what Dwight meant to the office. If you needed a cup of coffee in the morning, you needed a cup of Dwight. The day would not start correctly without Dwight saying hello. Seriously, Dwight's office was in the middle of the office. Literally in the middle. He was a source of energy. Dwight coming by your office to say hello meant so much. And I can tell you stories after stories. He'd come in to say hi to Miss Cheryl and say, hello, Miss Sunshine. He'd come by to Luz's office and say, Luz, how about my good morning? And if he didn't get that good morning, he'd say something like, I'm stunned. That was one of his sayings. He'd go to Sandy Ono, who was late price analyst, and give her a big hug from behind. Sandy pushed Dwight very, very hard because Sandy wanted Dwight to be the best price analyst, and those two had a special relationship. He called Josh Mr. Tesla. He called Bill Mr. New Guy. I mean, he had a name for everybody. But the thing about Dwight was he was sincere from the heart. Everything he did was from the heart, and he's very, very sincere. What you saw is what you got from Dwight. He cared about people, not just to say hello, but he wanted to get your reaction to see how you were doing as a person. Finding Dwight was easy, because all I had to do was find out where Kathy was. Wherever Kathy was, I'd find Dwight. If I was looking for Kathy, I'd find Dwight. Those two were inseparable. Just a little story about how they would get breakfast burritos every morning. I'd see Dwight going out to the parking lot and having lunch with Miss Joanne. Those two were inseparable when she was down in Fullerton, just commiserating, having lunch, talking amongst each other, going back and forth between the Jets and the Giants, and who was better. He'd do little things, like go to somebody's cubicle, like when Sharon was about to get married, and sprinkle glitter and put cards around her cubicle to say, hey, have a great wedding. He didn't have to do that. He really didn't have to do that, but Dwight did that. And I want the family to understand that, Eva, that Dwight's energy is something we all needed. And so we have an empty cubicle that, we'll always remember Dwight because of everything that he did for us. But the impact that he has had in the office is incredible. And we will never forget Dwight, and his legacy will live on forever. And Dwight, a little side story from me to you. Dwight loved tennis shoes. Nina knows he probably has a closet full. And Dwight and I got into this thing about shoes. And I said, well, then if you've got so many shoes, how come I don't see them? And he goes, well, don't trust me, they're still in the box. And I said, well, what's the point of putting them in the box if you're not going to wear them? I said, you got to show your other shoes some love. And so every morning he'd come in my office and he'd whip up his leg and say, look at these. Can you top these shoes? I mean, that's the kind of guy he was. He'd come up and give you a big hug when you wouldn't expect it, and it'd make you smile. So Dwight, I know you're looking down on us, hopefully with a big, big smile. You are represented by butterflies. It's an internal thing that came up within our office, and we've shared this with Nina. Where we see a butterfly, especially a yellow one, we know Dwight is watching over us. So Dwight, we love you. We'll love you forever. We're going to be okay. We'll take care of Nina. God bless you.
Good morning. My name is Rod Boskis, my wife Sherry. This is hard for me. Losing my parents, you know, it's tough for me to get up here. When you ask me to do it, so I'll do the best I can. So I guess you're gonna. My family and I have known Dwight and his family for over 15 years. Not only was he a perfect neighbor, he was a good friend. He is a great guy and will be missed very much by all of us. We didn't see much of him in the early years. We just see him coming and going in their cars and we wave. But whenever we had a party, he would always show up. He didn't want Eva at home. Said, well, you know, she didn't want to come, so. You know, and out of that, there's one night that really kind of always stuck in my head where it was someone's birthday. I think it was your birthday, he came over, and this time he stayed all night. Normally he would just come eat and then disappear. He stuck around, and he had a little too much. He was dancing with all the ladies. He was broke and everything. And then a couple days later, I'd seen him, and I said, "Hey, Dwight, you had a really good time on Saturday." He goes, "I did?" I goes, "Yeah, you were doing it." "No, I wasn't. I wasn't doing that." And to this day, he still denies it. And everybody knew it. You know, they would tell, "Yeah, Dwight, okay." I'm kind of going off my script, but I'll do the best I can. All right, yeah, referring to the shoes. Yeah, Dwight always was dressed to a T. I mean, I admired him for the way he looked. You know, I mean, he'd be out there mowing his yard, he'd be the man. I think it was longer than that is what he was wearing. And with the football, Dwight, you know, he's a big Jets fan. You know, why I don't know. They haven't been in the Super Bowl since what? Where they beat actually the Colts, which is one of our neighbors in the back, Brian, his favorite team. Sorry, Brian. You know, ever since we have a younger son, Seth, that
Dwight always made sure that Seth had a Jets jersey since he was a toddler. He grabbed it, here comes Dwight. Another jersey for Seth. Seth wore it proudly. Last Sunday, Jets were playing. We were outside talking to our other neighbors and talking about Dwight, laughing, good old memories. And here comes Seth with his Jets jersey. He's like, "Gotta represent Dwight. They're playing.
And Seth is a Green Bay fan. He never wears a jersey, but he just said, you know, I'm doing this for Dwight. His team's playing, and I'm going to support his team. And he said he's going to wear it every Sunday.
Every time Dwight went away, he's gone, you know, traveling for business. Here he come, knocking at the door, brings Seth a pen, magnet, with any little token of just, you know, something, but it meant the world to Seth. His eyes would light up and he'd say, "Wonder when Dwight's going away again." What's he doing this time? So those are the fond memories that will hold dearest to our heart forever. He was a warm and caring person. And he never mentioned it. We found out later that he used to take our youngest daughter to school when she'd miss her ride. He never said a word about it. That was their secret. But we found out later that he never told. We'll miss him yelling on game day.
No, not at you. But on game day, Sunday, you would hear him yelling, screaming, you know, saying words he probably shouldn't be. But you know, he loved his Jets. You know, I say in my letter, you know, is, he is this, he is that. And I say that because he is here and always will be. May you rest in peace and snore with the angels. Go Jets.
I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. What is. What was. What is now is now. And what forever is forever. To Juanita, Lorianne, Linnea, Brenda, Gwen Bay, deceased, yours truly, Dora, Lavinia. We love you, Dwight. Oh yes, we really do love you. Dwight, he dreamed it, he achieved it, and he believed it. But he, Dwight, he loved you more. Tis the old ship of Zion. Tis the old ship of Zion. Tis the old ship of Zion. Get on board. Get on. Get on board. He has landed.
Dwight LeBarion Culver was born on July 22, 1967, in Dothan, Alabama, to the late William Henry and Willa Jean Trawick Culver. Early in life, Dwight accepted Christ as his Savior. He continued following the Lord in his adult life as a member of the West Los Angeles Church of God in Christ, under the leadership of Bishop Charles E. Blake in Los Angeles, California. Dwight graduated from Dothan High School, and as a proud Tiger, he played football. After high school, he joined the United States Navy, where he served a 7-year tour on the USS Roosevelt. He worked in communications and was honorably discharged in 1992 after leaving the military business. At 25 years old, he owned his own cleaning business on Rodeo Drive in Beverly Hills, California. Dwight also had a love for entertainment. He received a certificate in entertainment publicity at University of Los Angeles in California in 1992. From there, his work experience expanded. He worked for California Highway Patrol, Walt Disney, Orion Metro Media, Daily Variety, and Miller's Brewery Company, where he had several positions as a dispatcher, media relations assistant, marketing executive assistant, and office assistant, respectively. His most notable career accomplishments was working for the Defense Contract Management Agency, a subsidiary of the United States Department of Defense. In 1997, Dwight met the love of his life and best friend, Nina Benton Culver. The two became inseparable and later married on December 4, 1999. He was a devoted husband, loving and protective father of two beautiful young ladies, Julianne Kimmel Culver and Lorian McCray. He also had a godson, Kyle Bubba Padilla, all of whom he loved very much. Dwight had a burning desire to learn. He attended the University of Laverne, where he received his Bachelor's of Science degree in Organizational Management in 2005, and his Master's of Business Administration in International Business, Marketing, and Supply Chain Management in 2007. The three concentrations he earned is a notable accomplishment, something never to be achieved at the university prior to 2007. He was a member of various organizations, National Black Masters of Business Association, Prince Hall Freemasonry, where he received his 32nd degree, California Young Democrats, American Federal Government Employees, Union Steward at Large. Dwight was a huge fan of sports, and his favorite sport was football. He loved the green and white. Anyone who knew him knew his favorite team was the New York Jets. His favorite cheer was Jets, 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 Jets. Many people loved Dwight because of his infectious sense of humor, outgoing personality, and heart of gold. He will be greatly missed. You may forget what he looked like or what he said, but you will never forget how Dwight made you feel. He always looked for the goodness in people. Many he precedes in death, his beloved father and mother, Sister Gwendolyn Babe Bradford, and his puppy, Cody. He leaves to mourn his wife, his children, his siblings, Brother Lanier, wife Ramona Culver of Detroit, Michigan, Sister Brenda, husband Kenneth Hairston of Killen, Texas, Sister Dora Sims of Dothan, Alabama, Sister Lavinia, husband Elder Samuel Williams of Dothan, Alabama, of Dothan, Alabama. Also a host of aunts, uncles, nieces, nephews, in-laws, cousins, and friends. A letter to my love, my husband, my best friend. We shared something for 19 years that some people never experience in a lifetime. And that was true love. We loved and protected each other in both good times and bad, no matter what. We were always together, did everything together, and I will miss that. I miss watching TV, laughing and joking with you. I miss our late night talks and sharing what happened during our day. I miss being your cheerleader, biggest supporter. I miss us having each other's backs. I will miss sharing an email address with you. We were so in sync that we shared the same birth year and month. I miss kissing your bald head while you sat at the computer. I miss us calling each other Pookie, as much as I hated that name. It sort of stuck just like you and me. I miss hugging you, kissing you, and your touch. I miss your smile, your scent, and hearing your voice. I miss you saying, "It's me and you against the world, baby." What I miss most is me telling you I love you and you being able to tell me the same. Love, always and forever. Juanita Nina, AKA Pookie.